Welcome back to AgriTalk. Today we are talking about the relaunch of the 4K clubs in our primary schools and why it is important to do that. Before the break, Anu, you're telling us about the patron, the president being the patron and the person that the kids will grow looking up to as their mentor. But also what I'm thinking is, while you are doing, you're going around the country on a fact-finding mission before, as you are thinking of reintroducing or relaunching the 4K clubs, what are some of the reasons that the current youth were giving not to be players or participants in the agricultural value chain, that now the reintroduction of this is meant to somehow fix some of that, those things that they came up with?
Okay. We actually received 11 key strategic issues from our consultations, because we were looking at the youth who is already out of school. We were also looking at the child, so that we could be able to address issues that are facing them across board, you know, as a child and also as a youth, so that we can be able to tailor a solution, because the engagement in the agriculture sector needs both exposure and then progressive nurturing till someone becomes of age. And from these issues, the issue of negative perception came up, negative attitude towards agriculture. Children and also youth thought it was not the very best of activities that they wanted to engage in. As they say, it looks shady, it was not cool enough, and so forth. So some of these things, some of these challenges we received, the youth themselves said they were the challenges which made them not want to really be involved in, because it was not cool enough for them to be involved into it. Others also say they lacked mentorship, they lacked information, knowledge. Others say they lacked land. Others say they lacked, affordable financing. And what we have done as government to be able to respond, because the government mandate is also to respond to the challenges that the citizens are facing, is we tailored programs that were then geared towards addressing some of these concerns. The revamped 4K clubs, then the remodeled version, which is aimed at addressing challenges or getting the child, you know, engaged in an agricultural activity, which is exciting, but of course also taking care of the modern child who also has a lot of technology around them. You know, also a child who has also grown seeing the other generation saying that agriculture is not cool. So how do we then present agriculture in a manner that is cool? And of course also diluting that negative effect that has always been there. Mm-hmm. So again, you'll find that even as we remodel the clubs, we've introduced the positive youth development model. And this model is aimed at, bringing up a holistic child. We will be using agriculture, of course, along the 5 thematic areas, but we want to then mold the character of a child, ensure that we have our child, even though they're in the 4K clubs, they're also able to articulate themselves, they are confident, they are compassionate to one another, you know, they are kind to one another, they are able to make connection with others, and they have that, you know, overall character. And when they have what we call the 5 C's, they are then able to contribute better to their societies, their homes, and even the country. And you'll find that not all these children eventually will end up in the agriculture sector, but having passed them through the positive youth development model, which is a research-based approach, these children will maybe end up in the medical field and will have very compassionate doctors that time, because the first thing that comes to their mind is, I have a responsibility of saving human life, other factors aside, because of that orientation. So we are using agriculture, fine, but using the positive youth development programming to also be able to bring an all-round child, mm-hmm. a child who is not only going to engage in the agriculture sector, but they will find themselves in other sectors, but again, they are, you know, a holistic human being. We also want to also have them enjoy, you know, the future, also being humane, because we've also noticed that we are not very, our humane nature also is declining a bit. So you also want to bring that back, but using agriculture. Again, also being able to expand the thematic areas so that they have a wide range of activities to choose from. And on this one, we are saying that they don't have to confine themselves to production alone. They can use technology. They can go to environment. They can go to any activity along the nutritional thematic area. They can go to any activity along the science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. They can go to any activity along production, that across crop production and development and livestock and fisheries. They can explore any activity along a thematic area. If it's environmental conservation, mm-hmm. we want them to think broadly alongside this thematic area. So we don't want to confine a child to our thought process as adults. It is just presenting the thematic areas, then the activity that they prompt, then our work is just to support them to be able to perfect that activity. Again, that is on the issue of the negative perception. A child, once they leave primary schools, then they will then be able to transition to high schools. Again, being able to anchor the programming along the Young Farmers Clubs, again, working very closely with the Agricultural Society of Kenya, so that the programming also can be able to be that of a child who is of an advanced kind of thinking. And then again, when these children transition from secondary school, they become out of school youth, then they can engage in programs such as Enable Youth, which gives them mentorship and financing through the 8 incubation centers that we have in the country. The youth themselves, from our consultations across the country, they say that they also didn't want to be funded by government as a group, mm-hmm. because we have many programs that we are implementing in the counties that support them in groups. And what the government did, and taking the instructions from His Excellency the President, is we designed programs that are then focusing on an individual. We find that the 520 youth who are now going to the incubation across the 8 incubation centers across the country, and these are the youth that His Excellency was unveiling and also you know, being able to usher them into the next phase of the incubation, you'll find that once they develop their proposals through mentorship, because again we are responding to what they said were the challenges. They said they lacked the mentorship, they lacked the basic training, they lacked the skills, they lacked the knowledge. So again, having them go into these institutions, we are going to take them through you know, mentorship, nurturing for about 3 to 6 months, depending on whether they are accelerating or they are standard. And then once that is done, we then give them, once we know they are now ready to be able to set up their own agricultural enterprises, we give them financing. And we have financing of 0% interest rate, 5%, and also a risk guarantee fund. So again, when we went around the country, some of these challenges, what they say, they don't want to be funded as a group, of which again, we also agree that at times you have that one person who can be able to set up their own successful enterprise and then employ 10 other people. That is still fine because they are providing employment. And even as we get them to develop their business plans and proposals and eventually setting up businesses, we want them to demonstrate how they can employ 5 others or 10 other youth in their enterprises.
Okay. Is there an age group that you are looking to start with? Or is the new the relaunch 4K clubs look at a particular age group, especially in primary schools?
Yeah, currently the guidelines as per the manual developed, we are saying we want to start them off from 8 years old up to 15 years old, that age bracket. But it's not cast in stone. So should we see that a child of a lesser age, less than 8 years old, is also interested, mm-hmm. We are not going to lock them out. We'll find a way of also being able to incorporate that kind of an interest so that we can be able to anchor it and even support it further. But okay. This one is on a case-to-case basis, depending on what we are seeing the kids' interest to be.
Okay. I also see you dressed in a very beautiful uniform. Is it part of the 4K club?
Actually, in the rebranded version of the 4K clubs, we have now an official regalia for every categories, mm-hmm. where we have His Excellency the President having his own regalia, as you saw him relaunching. When he was launching the revival, he also had donned his own regalia. So that is the regalia for the patron, and also at the national level also, we have the Cabinet Secretary in charge of Agriculture, that is Honorable Peter Munya. He also has his own regalia. And you saw how he looked from the shirt to the scarf and also to the beret and also to the what you call we also have customized pins for the club, for the school clubs, and also for also the different categories, patron level and also the deputy patron. For the governor level, we also have the governors also having their own regalia. The governors are the patrons in their respective counties. So the governors also have their own chart. Of course, it has two different strips, different from that one of His Excellency and also the deputy patron. Mm. Again, they also have their own scarf and the beret. At the sub-county level, we have designed regalia for the sub-county agricultural officers and the ward agricultural officers. And at the institutional level, we've designed regalia for the school patron and also for the 4K club members. Why we are designing also is also we want to have an identity. Because again, we said we also want to, the kids want to be part of something that is exciting, something that you're able to quickly identify and want to be a part of. So in the wake of us saying that we want to have an activity that is cool, we also start with overall how we present it, how we make it appealing, how we brand the whole club activity. And many a times it has been said that agriculture needs to be made cool and all that. Again, we need to make it cool, we need to make it presentable, we need to make it appealing, and also make it practical, because for the youth who is already out there who has a family and they need to feed their family, they need to make it practical and also rewarding. But for this child who's young, we need to make it cool that through the club activities, through also how we present it, so that they can then have the curiosity and, you know, just the, that's that drive to want to be part of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
You also talked about a reward system. Mm-hmm. How will this reward system work?
The reward system, the presidential award scheme, we will be implementing it and we are actually, through the youth unit, we are developing the guidelines on the criteria for the awards. But the best performing club member at the institutional level will be awarded by the school patron. Mm-hmm. And then the sub-county and the ward level by the sub-county and agricultural officers and the ward agricultural officers. At the county level, the governor will do the award, and at the national level, it is His Excellency the President who will do the award. Again, guidelines are being developed to be able to guide that kind of the presidential award scheme. To be able to also ensure that all these programs from the 4K club to the young farmer clubs and also youth who are already out of school, a youth unit within the ministry has already been constituted. We have a fully fledged unit now, which is going to be handling the issues of youth in agriculture. And the work of the youth unit is not only to implement the 4K club activities, but also to coordinate other activities in relation to the youth. Mm-hmm. You'll find that we've already put in place the implementation framework, where we have at the very apex, we have the cabinet secretary in charge of Ministry of Agriculture, that is Honorable Peter Munya, and four other ministries that we are collaborating with. That is Ministry of Education, ICT, Water, and Environment. So at that particular interministerial committee, we have five cabinet secretaries sitting at that level, who then give us strategic guidance to be able to you know, guide the club activities. Again, at that level, we have the project steering committee, which is composed of the PSAs and also a few development partners that also interfuse the project steering committee, so that we can be able then to agree on how the activities will be done and also what kind of partners are doing what program for us to be able to synchronize. Mm-hmm. Again, now that feeds into the technical committee, which has two officers from each collaborating ministry. Like you'll find from the Ministry of Environment, we have a liaison officer who has been tasked with the activity of the 4K clubs. To coordinate with the Ministry of Agriculture. So the activities in relation to the 4K clubs are also coordinated. So all this feeds to the youth unit. And the youth unit now, which is in charge of coordination and also implementation, also bringing in together the JASCOM, the Joint Sector Agricultural Secretariat, so that we can also be able to coordinate and form the same structures even at the county level, through the Ministry of Education and also the county government, Ministries of Agriculture. So the same coordination that you see from the national side, national government side. We also want it replicated at the county government side so that we can also be able to seamlessly implement the program. The youth unit, again, even as we draw the guidance from the interministerial committee, right now the next phase of the of work for this the unit now is now we are moving towards now building the capacity of the school patrons, and then also that of the county staff that will be handling this program, because we also want them to build their capacity around the positive youth development model, so that they can also have the right knowledge of how they're supposed to handle these children in relation to these club activities. Again, remember how you also speak to a child, the tone at which you apply to speak to this child can either, you know, give them cold feet, make them disinterested, or chase them away from the activity altogether. So again, being able to take the patrons through the positive youth development model, there's a way we expect them to also be able to engage with this child. Again, the negative words, we want them dropped completely. You know, those negative words which drain a child's spirit. You remember, you know, telling someone that if you don't read, you'll end up being a farmer. You know, that continuous pronunciation of such words make these kids want to run away from the activity. So even how they're handled, also bringing up a holistic being through the positive youth development model is some of the things that we want to build the capacity of the counties and also the teachers on, so that even as we move to handle the club activities, we also have a holistic approach. Remember, we are not only focusing on the thematic areas alone, but we also want to use the thematic areas to also bring up a holistic child, a child who can be able to express him or herself in front of others, who's confident, who has a good character, who's able to, you know, just relate with that, plus make connections and all that. But we want to use agriculture to be able to also mold that child.
Okay. You talked about replication of some of the national events, especially in county governments, and closer to these children. I remember you you spearheaded the development of a model farm at the Ministry of Agriculture. Is that what you want to see also being replicated all over the country, close to kids, and where they can walk, see new technologies like what you talked about, aquaponics, hydroponics, all those things, and get them thinking, what else can I do on my own? Is this something I can do at home, or we can do it at school?
We want to see kids engaging in all range of activities around the five thematic areas. We find that those kids who, when we were doing the launch, we had kids who are quite interested in the thematic area on STEM. They had a weather station. They would explain how weather data is collected, how it's analyzed, relating the data collected to, you know, articulating issues of how that data is able to support us in decision making, articulating relation of soil moisture to crop production, soil texture to crop production. You know, these are things also that they learn in the classroom, but being able to see them articulate that practically is something quite exacting, especially in relation to the agriculture sector. So these kids can set up whatever kind of innovations that they feel they need to set up. From what we've set up at the ministry, the model, because we've modeled about 10 technologies, which we documented and we gave to the counties and all the other stakeholders who had an interest in that. Again, also supporting the schools through these technologies, because the technologies are already there and they've been documented. Should the kids' interest gear them towards using these technologies for crop production, the better, because we develop this material for them. And again, we also want to use children as also agents of knowledge transfer, so that whatever they learn at home, from school, they also take it back home. And they go and we expect them to also set up an activity at home together with their parents, so that we can also be able to help each other in terms of the extension line. Whatever these kids also learn from home, there's no harm of in them taking the same knowledge back to school, so that, you know, it can be like, you know, a platform where they exchange, they learn, and also help also, you know, us talk to the to their parents through the technical bit of the whole agricultural value chain. So we want them to learn, exchange knowledge amongst each other from their parents, and also having their parents who are the first point of contact with the children, encourage them, guide them even further, but also us giving them the technical support that is needed to be able to guide the process.
Okay. Today is also the World Food Safety Day. Advice can you give us about what do you want these kids to learn when it comes to producing of safe food for all of us? Because someone told me, well, if food is not safe, then it's not food.
Yeah, it's true. Actually, what we know in our 30s, in our 50s, or in our 70s, is what we must teach these kids when they are this young. Even about food safety, whatever we know right now as adults, we have to break it down to a language that they understand in their small age.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is how we ensure that they have a continuous nurturing, continuous guidance. And you'll find that through that nurturing, continuous nurturing, the sustained nurturing, they will be able to come up with solutions, better solutions to their future. So even things like food safety, we also want to inculcate what we still do with the other farmers, but bring the same knowledge to the club activities. Of course, breaking it down to a language that these kids can understand. And you'll be very surprised that these kids they have a mental capacity that you can't even comprehend. They are such critical thinkers. They're very brilliant, and we just want to use that critical thinking just to stimulate an idea in their minds so that they can start seeing these challenges. Slowly, as they gradually develop, they see the challenge, they start looking for small solutions. Then as they grow older, they'll start having mega solutions to mega challenges.
Okay.
So that is a kind of inculcation of a culture that you want to see, but that one has to start through nurturing and mentorship.
Okay. So as you relaunch these 4K clubs in school, what support do you expect from teachers, parents, society, their siblings who are already out there, like some of us? How can we support this project and our young kids?
Yeah, I think that's a very good question, Philip. We have every child comes from a family setup, and every one of us has a little one, a young one in our households. Every one of us has a small sister, a small brother, a child. We all have those little ones within our family setups. And just by the fact of us knowing that in the event we are not there, that these children, once we support them to get the necessary life skills, these kids will be able to feed themselves, whether we are there or not, or whether we are capable of providing or not. Just giving them that life skill is what we need to do. And for us to be able to do that, we must speak the right words. Let's not kill their spirit by using, you know, bad words, you know, words that discourage you or make you feel like you're not worthy or capable. Also having parents, also teachers, anyone who interacts with a child, stakeholders, staff, technical staff, you know, just encouraging the children and helping them perfect their ideas. Again, as adults, we don't want to be dictative.
Mm-hmm.
We just want to be facilitative so that we can give them a space where they express what they want to do. If it's the proceeds from the club activities, we should not, you know, as adults, dictate how they should use their proceeds. It is for us to guide them how they need to use their proceeds, but we shouldn't even take the proceeds from their club activities and put those proceeds in our own pockets. So what we need to do is, everyone has a responsibility to these young ones, from how we speak to how we handle them, but just giving them that encouragement, be able to learn, and also encourage them to join these club activities and then further guide them. But also the negative words need to stop.
Okay.
At least with the revival, we all agree that issues of saying when you don't read, you work hard in school, you'll end up becoming a farmer, those are words that are in the past, and
okay,
it's not fashionable to say that anymore.
Okay. Thank you very much, Anne, for sparing time to be with us today. We've learned a lot, we've heard a lot, and we're expecting great things going forward, especially from our kids. They have great minds, and as a country, you know, our resources, the young people, And the reintroduction of the 4K clubs is the right way to go. And we promise you, as a KTN Farmers TV, we will work with you in this journey. We will make sure that the 4K clubs become a success and nurture good citizens, good farmers in the future. And for viewers back at home, that is it from us today. Let's make farming cool again. Until next time, goodbye.